How are you feeling? How many weeks left to your fight now? We're counting the weeks already.
Five.
That's exciting.
Yeah, I think it's really six, but like five with training.
And how's camp going?
We're ready. Good. Camp's going good. I'm feeling good, strong, explosive, sharp.
I've been around boxing many, many years. I've never seen someone so determined and focused like you are right now. Like, you don't care if you're fighting Godzilla, King Kong. Nothing's going to stop you.
Nah, you know, I'm in a good place right now in life and in this moment of time, and I'm just enjoying it every day.
What did you make of the whole Ryan Garcia suspension, and Haney says he wants to sue him for hurting his feelings?
I think it was good that they suspended him just because, you know, that's not right. You know, I think it's fair for Devin Haney. And then as far as him suing Ryan, I don't know.
It's kind of soft, I'm sorry. Like,
that's just,
you have a problem with him?
That's how he wants to go about it, you know?
That's his business. Okay, so it looks like he not vacated, but Sandor Martin is going to fight Alberto Preo for the title. And what do you think about that? Who wins that one?
I think that's a good fight. What's his name? Alberto?
Alberto.
I think Alberto takes it. I think he deserves that title shot because he fought hard, he fought disciplined with Gary Russell, and, you know, I'll be looking forward to it.
They're right. You've been around boxing many years. People are starting to give you your love after last fight. I feel like Tank is getting love now after all these years that he's done so many great things. Why is that? Why now Ring Magazine put him number one at 35? ESPN, that never said anything nice about him, 4 posts in a row saying good things. What is it?
You know, that's a good question. I think because fighters are losing now. You got like Devin Haney lost, he beat Ryan Garcia, Teofimo lost. But you know, his Tank is still undefeated and he's still knocking guys out. So I think, I believe that's why, maybe, you know.
Well, I also believe some of it is because he's about to fight Loma.
Oh, yeah.
So Ring Magazine want to be part, which I get it, ring title. So put him number one, Loma number two. That means they're fighting for the ring belt. Then it gives him a lot of buzz. Then ESPN, he's fighting Loma. It's an ESPN fight, too. So, okay, breakdown Tank and Loma.
I think that's a great fight. I think right now, in this moment of time, I'll probably edge with Tank just because he's young. I think he's in his prime. But never count Lomachenko out. He has great skill, great trainer with him, and a lot of experience. So if he was to, you know, upset him, you know, I wouldn't be surprised because, you know, he's a great fighter.
What about one more? Shakur and Tank. Do you like that fight?
Yeah. It's another good fight. That's an interesting fight. Because Shakur moves a lot. He doesn't risk much. But, Tank has great experience. We see what he does with his lockdown game and sets his shots up. So it'd be a great fight.
By the way, who told Mario to wrap hands like that? He's an artist. He's a Picasso. That's pretty good. Took you a long time to get it down like that?
Yeah.
Is it a style that's known? Is it someone that taught you, Mario? Who? Yeah, I know, but who taught you? Nacho?
Nacho with his style, yeah.
Nacho's the man.
You watch a little bit of everybody.
Does it feel good? You feel comfortable?
Yeah.
You like it? It looks like well protected. It
protects my knuckles. It's hot.
It's hot, and then this weekend, Bam is fighting. I'm excited. He's fighting Guy Estrada. What do you guys think?
That's a great fight. You know, I'm very excited for him. He works so hard, you know, and he's young, and I think he deserves the magnitude of the fight, and I think he wins.
He just headed to the airport today. He has a whole week in Phoenix to promote and do all that. And then Virgil, I read on the internet, has a fight. Virgil is going to fight Sergey Baranchuk, the interim 154 WBC title.
I didn't even know that.
He's like 24-1 with 23 knockouts.
Oh, yeah. Busy, you know, summer for RGBS.
Yeah, but you're happy. You're in a good place. You can't wait for fighting. You wish it was August 3rd already.
Yep, I'm ready.
Are you going to get a rhyme ready for Eminem when you meet him? You're going to tell him, hey, I got a rhyme for you? Do you rap?
No,
you never rap? You never wrote?
I can barely speak English.
You can do it in Spanish, reggaeton or something.
I can barely speak Spanish. Nah, I feel like both of my languages, they're not so.
I know what you're saying, because at home you speak Spanish.
Yeah, at home I speak
But in school
Spanish.
You spoke English, so. But let me ask you this. Are you going to give out like a 10,000 or 5,000 Mexican flags with Team Ryu on it to let people know you were born in Mexico?
I think people will know I'm born in Mexico once I beat it.
When they see your hands do the talking. And last thing, right? How has sparring been so far in camp?
Good, man.
Because you've been training before you had the official fight, before it was announced, and you're already in shape. Can you tell a difference?
How many weeks have I been here already? Alexis, how many weeks have you been here?
These are
13 better. Wow. 4 months.
13 weeks.
It feels like 2 weeks, right?
Yeah.
That means it's good.
I've been enjoying it. I could stay here a whole year if I had to. Getting better. That's what I like to do.
But I'm saying, from your own perspective, do you notice you're sharper, you're hitting harder, you're...
Yeah.
Tank always says a happy fighter is a dangerous fighter. How dangerous is Ryu right now?
I feel like I'm the most dangerous I've ever been. At 140, I feel strong.
Mario, when you move up in weight, do you get stronger when you go up in weight?
Yeah.
Por qué? Why?
Strong because you eat very good.
You don't have to cut as much. You don't have to kill yourself to make weight.
I think it depends too. Some lose power, but I think in my case, I'm already
Tall.
Big for the weight.
Yeah. What are you? 5'10", 5'11"?
Yeah.
So. The speed, so that's good.
Yeah, speed and power. Another day at the office. Is today a sparring day?
Yeah.
Do you love it? Is this what you look forward to the most, Ryan? Why?
As a kid.
Why is that?
Just because I feel like that's where you learn, that's where you...
You perfect what you've been working on.
You know, you work on what you need to work on. At the moment, the sparring, the speed, everything. You know, since I was little, right? When I was training with Mario, I used to want to spar every day.
James Tony sparred every day.
And he used to get mad, like, man, go hit the bag.
Do you know Chavez Sr. never worked mitts in his life?
Really?
Except when he trained with Emmanuel Sr. for a little window. James Tony also told me, don't do mitts. Just a bag and spar.
Yeah. I mean, everybody, you know, different flows from different flows.
But you love all of it, but sparring's the most.
Yeah.
Do you have your outfit ready already? You got stuff like that? You still working on it?
I have time still. But I should probably do that soon. I kind of be forgetting sometimes.
You're busy. You're focused. But the fight's gonna be here before you know. Like I said, with Bam's fight, I feel like the 6 weeks, 7 weeks, 8 weeks.
Yeah, he did. I feel like he had just got here like a week ago.
New shoes?
Yeah.
Emmanuel Sud used to love this brand. They're from Japan, right?
Yeah, Mizuno.
Why does he like them so much?
Who?
Can you tell the difference, you, in the brand?
Yeah, I mean, for me, since I'm gonna be fighting using my feet, using, you know, all my abilities.
So you want something you like, confident?
They're good.
They're light?
They're light. My feet. Especially if you have blisters on your feet.
Yeah, no, you can't have it. That's why you should always break your shoes in. I've seen fighters wear their fight night shoes the fight of the night. That's what they get stuff. You need to break them in like at least a couple weeks, right?
Yeah.
So everybody, where do they follow you on social media, Ryan?
You can follow me at Ryo Boxing.
If you follow him and tune in August 3rd, will be fireworks.
Shock the world. Thank you, everybody, who's been supporting me.
Another day at camp, another day at the office, getting ready with the team. It's very hot outside, very hot inside.
Hot.
Nobody should have a problem making weight in this heat. By the way, Robert, do you have any pets? Dogs, cats, alligators, crocodiles?
Nah.
No pets.
I don't. I do want a dog, though.
It's a commitment. It's like having a kid.
You have a dog?
I have a dog and a kid. If the kid doesn't wake me up at 4 in the morning, the dog does. She wants to eat. She goes by her bowl and starts barking. My wife's mad at me because she's like, you trained her to do that. She taught herself. She'll bark until I get up. But what breed would you want to get, you know?
German Shepherd.
Those are good dogs. Security. There's an old saying. Don't be scared of the dog. Don't be scared of the dog, be scared of the owner. there you have it, Ryu and Cam getting ready for Pitbull Cruise August 3rd. You do not want to miss it. It's going down in Los Angeles. Tickets are already on sale. And Mario's ready.
Yes, I'm ready.
Ryu's ready, getting ready. Sparring day today. Stay tuned. FayezNewsReporting.com. I'm Eli Segbag reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Segbag. You can follow me on Instagram @Eli Segbag.